But be of the question, what does it say?
List any three derived quantities.
Any three derived quantities. Now, may I mention that on these physical quantities, they are split into two. We have the basic quantities and the derived quantities. These basic are also known as what? Fundamental quantities. They are seven fundamental quantities or basic quantities. And then from these basic quantities, you can derive the quantity. Then you have derived quantities. And these derived quantities come from the fundamental quantities. And there are so many of them. Now, apart from just answering the question, as a way of revision, let me go through the seven fundamental quantities that each of you is supposed to know in the field of engineering. The seven fundamental quantities are, let me start with mass. Length, time, mass in kgs, length in meters, time in seconds.
Seconds.
Furthermore, we have what is known as amount of matter. Amount of matter. Measured in moles. Then we also have electrical current. Measured in ampere. Then we also have luminous intensity measured in candela. That's where the word candle comes from. And then we also have thermodynamic temperature measured in Kelvin. These are the seven fundamental quantities. And out of these quantities, this is where we get what are known as the derived quantity. So, peradventure, the question said, define a derived quantity. Define a derived quantity. What would be your answer to such a question? What would be your response? This is a quantity that is as a result of multiplication, division, or both of a basic or fundamental quantity. Now, this is English. What do we mean? What we are simply saying here is that from the seven fundamental quantities, when you multiply or divide or both division or multiplication, then what you get is a derived quantity. Please, the key word is the multiplication and division, not addition or subtraction. No. If you have 7 meters minus 2 meters, the answer is 5 meters. So you have a basic quantity minus a basic quantity. What you get is still a basic quantity. That's what a derived quantity. 7 meters plus 2 meters, you get 9 meters. This is still a basic quantity. But when you have 7 meters multiplied by 2 meters, what you get is 14 meter squared. This is not a basic quantity. This qualifies now to be what is known as a derived quantity. So a derived quantity is as a result of a multiplication or division or both of a basic quantity. So area is a derived quantity. Length is a basic quantity. So we get back to the question, which says that list 3 derived quantities. So 3 derived quantities are any of the quantities which you know apart from the 7. Example, volume measured in meter cubed is a derived quantity. Velocity, meters per second, is a derived quantity. Another one, density, kgs per meter cubed, is a derived quantity. Those are the derived quantities. They are as a result of multiplication or division or both of the basic quantities. So, ladies and gentlemen, the questions on quantities in an exam will be based on the following. Number one, physical quantity. Anything that is measurable. Number two, you need to distinguish between basic, rather fundamental, or and derived quantities. And thirdly, you should be able to carry out conversions. Truth be told, engineering science, next week, Tuesday, 22nd of December, in the year 2021, there will be a question on quantities. We proceed. But see, what does Part C say?
Part C, Part C says, what do the acronyms MKS stands for?
So, MKS, okay, good. So, among the fundamental qualities, they are the first three, the most important ones. Mass, length and time. Okay? Very, very important. Even you, when you were born the first day, the first thing the nurses could do was to measure your mass. How many kgs? 1.8. Some of you were even less than 1 kg. And now, because you are more than 60 kgs, you think you are very powerful. You should be very good. So, first thing is the mass. Secondly, artificial intelligence, time. Very, very important.
Okay.
So, these three are the most very, very critical quantities. So, M for meter, K for kilogram, S for second. So when they say MKS, this is meter, kilogram, second, which is the SI unity system. Otherwise, some countries they use FPS, MKS, meter, kilogram, second. What about FPS? Foot.
Oh.
Pound. Second. The FPS system. There is also CGS system, which was being used even in Zambia some years back. Centimeter, grams, and seconds. So in this paper, they only ask about the FPS, I mean about the MKS. I have given you two more, and those are the only ones in your syllabus, unless they included one today, which I'm not yet aware. And that is an example of an empty set, meaning it is not there. Proceed. Proceed with
conversion.
Question two.
Convert the unit to SI unit. 250 macro amp.
Convert the units. 250 microamps. Okay, so this is the 250 multiplied by 10 to the power micro is negative what? Milli negative 3, micro negative 6 amps, or 0.12325 amps. That is the answer. 10 to the power negative 6, it means the decimal point moves from here 6 points to the left. Standard 4, grade 9 and 8, Chasa Secondary School, 1992. We proceed. Number 2. Mr. Kunika, number two. -1 × 10⁻⁴ ⁻⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ ⁹ Tell your roommates to follow also if you are writing level one.
No, she's level three.
Ah, good.
Okay.
We proceed. Next question. You can copy question three. Since Mr. Kunika has decided to stop reading the questions, define the term uniform acceleration. What is acceleration? Change of speed per unit time. That is acceleration. Okay? Change of speed per unit time. That is the acceleration. What about uniform acceleration? Uniform acceleration is simply constant change of speed per unit time. 1 mark. Acceleration. Change of speed per unit time. Uniform acceleration is the constant change of speed per unit time. We proceed. An acceleration, an electron in an oscilloscope accelerates uniformly from rest to a speed of, from rest, meaning initial velocity u is equal to zero, that is from rest, to a speed of 5 × 10⁵. So final speed v 5 × 10⁵ meters per second in 2 microseconds time 2 × 10⁻⁶ seconds. Sketch the speed time graph. Sketch the speed time graph. So, speed time graph, ladies and gentlemen, when they say speed time graph, the first quantity to be mentioned is always on the vertical. So, we are going to have speed here because the question says speed time graph. There are two quantities here, speed and time. The first quantity to be measured is always on the vertical. So we put speed here in meters per second. The second quantity to be measured is always on the horizontal. time here in seconds. So, starting from rest here at zero, a straight line, this is uniform acceleration. Up to there. Here, we put the time, 2 microseconds. And here we put the speed. So here we are going to write the time in microseconds. And then here we'll put the value of what? 2. Here is meters per second. Here we put 5 times 10 to the power 5. That is the speed time graph for this question. Next part of the question says, how far did the electron go in 2 microseconds? How far? This simply means the distance covered. Okay? And when you have a graph, the distance covered is the area under the graph. Just calculate this area. That will be your distance. As you can see here, this is a triangle. So area of a triangle half times the base, which is 2, times 10 to the power micro, negative 6. Multiplied by 5, which is the height, times 10 to the power negative, the power positive, 5. And when you put scissors there, you are going to find that you simply have 1 times, this will be 1, times 5, times 10 to the power negative 1, which is 0.5 meters. That's the distance covered. Peradventure, you say, no, me, I don't know how to use this one very distance. I know the one according to Abbott Physics, page 17, which says that S is equal to S distance covered is equal to half U plus V multiplied by T. So your distance will be half U, 0. V, 5 times 10 to the power negative, to the power positive 5. T times 2 times 10 to the power negative 6. So, this will be half 5 times 10 to the power 5 times 2 times 10 to the power negative 6. It will still come back to 0.5 meters. Okay? The next part of the question What was the acceleration? What was the acceleration? From V is equal to U plus AT. Our A is equal to V minus U over T. So our V was E. 5 times 10 to the power 5 minus U 0 over T 2 times 10 to the power negative 6. What does this give us? This is 5 over 2 times 10 to the power 5 divided by 10 to the power negative 6. 5 over 2 is 2.5 times 10. To the power 5 minus negative 6 indices greater 2.5 times 10 to the power 11 meters per second squared. Ladies and gentlemen, this marks the end of revision in engineering science. Thank you. You know where to find me. Bless you. Good night.